Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for December the 19th of 2019, well, it is titled Apollo 17's Moonship. So what do we see here? Well, this is the part of the lunar module for the Apollo 17 mission. And this is actually the what we call the ascent stage. This is the part that brought the astronauts off the moon. So if you've seen the lunar landers, they look a little bit different. This is actually the top portion of the lunar lander, essentially. And the lower portion remains at the Apollo 17 landing site. That's what we call the descent stage. That was to take the astronauts down to the moon. And this is the one to bring them up off of the moon. Now you may look at that and think that it doesn't look very aerodynamic, and that is correct. And if you think about that, although we tend to look at spaceships as being aerodynamic from a science fiction point of view, perhaps, in reality, something traveling through space that is not traveling through an atmosphere does not experience any kind of resistance. So we're very used to making things like airplanes and automobiles here on Earth very aerodynamic to make it more efficient as you cut through the atmosphere to minimize the air resistance and drag. However, out in space, that does not exist. So the moon has no atmosphere. So it doesn't take anything extra, any odd shape, even like this, can travel just as easily through it as a nice aerodynamic rocket shape. So it's one of the things to think about when we travel out in space. A spaceship that is not meant to travel in an atmosphere does not have to have those nice smooth contours to it that we associate with air travel here on the Earth. Now we can also see, how do we control the rocket then? Well, there are the rocket engines. The main engine down below is what would have been used to lift off from the moon. Much smaller than the large rockets needed to lift off of the Earth. The moon's gravity is much less than the gravity of the Earth, and we do not have to push through an atmosphere. So the Saturn V rocket that lifted these astronauts off of the Earth not only had to escape from the Earth's gravity, but had to push through the atmosphere of the Earth as well. Here we just needed the main rocket plus some maneuvering rockets to allow this to be able to come and dock with the command module, which is where the picture was taken from, and to allow the astronauts to come back onto the command module, which would return them to Earth. There are also thrusters along the side that would allow them to adjust their course so that they could line up properly. So just those two sets of engines that were needed to be able to do to travel. And one of the other things, again, we do not have that air resistance, so you need thrusters to speed up and to adjust your direction. But once you're moving in a certain direction, you will continue to do so. So you have to also take that into consideration. Not only do you have to speed up, but you can't just take your foot off the accelerator, so to speak, and slow down. If you're going at a certain speed, you will continue moving at that speed and have to then slow yourself down. So the rockets have to be fired to slow down the craft as it approaches the command module as well. And this moonship, as we see, is now back on the surface of the moon, and in fact was crashed into the surface of the moon after the astronauts had safely transferred back to the command module. This was jettisoned, crashed back into the surface of the moon, where it remains essentially a pile of debris today. So that was our picture of the day for December the 19th of 2019. It was titled Apollo 17's Moonship. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.